Okay, hi, this is part three of episode 10B of Drive Time Season 3. Did you get all that? I was just talking about movies, specifically movies that I've seen recently and also movies that I know are out there that are maybe caught, I'm not going to talk about, Fast and Furious. I have no opinion on Fast and Furious. I've never seen a single Fast and Furious movie in my life. I have no opinion. Can't say. I know it. I think it's making a lot of money, but I have no opinion on it. I have zero opinion on anything about it. I do have some opinions on, and I talked about this on this very show the other day, so I'm not going to get into too much. I'm just going to list movies I know that are out there playing now movies type of movies. And I'm in three of them I can think of. I think that's what we're going to do. First one I talked about the other day, This Is the End. I guess it seems like a movie I might see just because it's a summer movie and some comedy. You know, just looking for like a mainstream comedy, that would be a fun one to maybe go see. And I'm pretty sure like it will live up to exactly what my expectations are for it. It won't be bad, but it won't be blow me away. Like a comedy that blew me away in the last few years that I saw, I think it's one of the best comedies ever, was Forgetting Sarah Marshall. I still think that movie, out of all of these recent movies, with that crew of actors, that incorporates some or all of them, I'm talking like Paul Rudd's and the Jason Segel, although none of these guys are in This Is the End, other than Jonah Hill, I don't think. I don't know if Paul Rudd is in that. But, that was really good, but I don't expect it to be any better than, you know, just kind of average, good, solid comedy, like Pineapple Express level, I would say. That's where I would, if I had to hope for what to get out of that movie. Next, the Superman movie. I'm a little intrigued by the Superman movie. I think Michael Shannon's an awesome actor. I love, like, a lot of his movies. So, I mean, I think it's an interesting role he's in. I think, Russell Crowe, whatever, like, give or take that. The guy playing Superman, it seems kind of dark. A little bit of backstory. I don't know anything about who directed it or anything. And I'm probably not going to ever see it. But if someone on a whim suggested, let's see this, I'd be like, alright, I'd check that out. I'm not like anti, which is like how I was with like the Spider-Man franchise after the first one, the Tobey Maguire one, although they rebooted that again with somebody else too. I totally lost, and I loved Spider-Man as a little kid, it was my favorite comic, but that was completely lost to me. I hated the first one with Tobey Maguire. So that's my thoughts about Spider-Man. The other one, I want to talk about the Magician movie. Something about that makes me think like that would be an interesting movie to see. And I would probably enjoy it. Like more so than it maybe either than one would assume, or even more than like it. With it, whatever the general consensus is of how good it actually is. Does that at all make any sense? I don't know. I like, what's his name? I was about to say the Jewy guy. That's not nice at all. Why would I say that? Why would you say that? Jesse Eisenberg. You know what I was just thinking? I was like, Jesse Eisenberg. But then I was like, no. That's a Jewish character he played in the movie's name. Not his own name. But not the case. That was his own. That's his real name. A couple other movies that I know of that are out that doesn't look like I'm going to get around to. Mud is playing at the movie Mud with Matthew McConaughey. That's pretty alright. That's playing at a small theater right near my house, so I actually could get to that one night. It's not impossible, but very unlikely. I don't know what to think of it. It could, you know, it's one of those ones I just don't have any idea if it'd be horrible or surprisingly good. Well, I saw a commercial for a very weird movie with Jodie Foster and Matt Damon. It was some sort of sci-fi movie. These are the coming attractions now for movies that I'm pretty sure aren't out. There's that. There's Ender's Game. I think this is summer. Maybe even... That might not even be later. But Ender's Game was a book I read several times as a kid. It's a sci-fi book by Orson Scott Card. And that would just be interesting to, like, maybe create some sort of flashback scenario in my head. Pine for my childhood. That was bad traffic we just got out of. It's gonna extend my ride. I'm already a little late. Is that enough for movies? Talk about movies enough? I usually don't talk about pop culture stuff. I like pop culture. I have nothing against pop culture. Pop culture's fine. Rest of development? Okay, much better. I have 60-70% of the way through the fourth season on the Netflix / you know, how one would procure those type of... Procure? God, I fuck up some words that I just know are not hard, but when I try and say them, I'm like, wait, do you even know what you're talking about? Procure. I know that word. I doubt myself when I go to say it. I'm just not good. Like, I'm a horrible speller. So, if I use that word in a sentence, if I'm typing online, I can get it right just by spell check or corrected. So I think somewhere along the line, that definitely it kind of fucks up how you talk. I think I'm trying to think of the best way to phrase what I'm thinking about. But, like, if you don't have if you're not inclined to have, like, good, like, vocab, spelling, like, memory. I think a lot of this is muscle memory. Not muscle memory. Well, fuck. Just memory. Mental memory. Jesus Christ. God, how could I sound stupider by the second? Digging my own grave here. Digging my own fucking grave. I'm not that. I'm sorry. I'm not that in the heart of myself. My hair is not doing what I wanted to today. It's my biggest problem. I might try to avoid getting a haircut for a while, like trimming the back of my own head. How about that? That's a good topic. So I just stopped trying to do my hair and look fucking very, very well. I'm driving, crash, burn. There used to be a good dollar store on the left-hand side of this strip mall. I'm going to fix the camera. Sorry for me touching it again. Just hit the time, too. Is it 8? No, this one is... I might just end it after this, because, God, I can't dump and go again. Plus, we're, like, not that far away. Shades, can't put my... Sorry. It's a lot of talking. Going on 40 minutes. 40 minutes. Holy. I'm debating on which way I should go. Should I go the highway or the other way? I'm running late though, I should just get on that. How am I hitting more traffic than it's worth? that maneuver I just did, changing lanes. This is actually dangerous, semi-dangerous area. There's a lot of accidents around here. It's very busy. I've driven it so many times that I feel like I can give up some of my attention to this talking that I'm doing. But you gotta be careful. You gotta be careful a little bit. You can't see it, but this is a circle. And these cars coming on my left, they have the right of way, so kind of waiting for your window. And that's how you do it. Been to that diner. I used to go to that diner all the time when I was in high school. That's right. I don't live that far away from where I grew up. I don't think that's explicitly a bad thing, but I think more often than not, that paints the picture. I think I want to write a novel by hand. And I actually started doing this yesterday. And I'm going to lay it out for you right now. Now, this novel, I'm envisioning in my head to be long. One thing I haven't done is written a proper novel. And I say that nonchalantly, but it's true. It's something I feel like I can do and I should do, and I'm not that young now. I'm 32 years old, so what am I waiting for? There's plenty of people who are my age who have already written several novels. And if I want to write the most novels, well, no, I don't. I don't know if I have that aspiration. I want to write the most songs of all time. I don't know if I could also write the most novels. Although, wouldn't that be something that the guy who wrote the most songs ever also wrote the most novels? People will think back in like the year 2087, like, what could he not do? He was a good cook too? Oh my god. Going on the highway, that sealed the deal. See, I could have gone right there. Putting on the fake AC just to get a little cool in here. It doesn't really work, but it sort of works. It's not very hot out, but the AC works when it's not hot. Like, it can actually, it'll work when it's like cool air outside. It's funny like that. There's no traffic here though, so this was the right choice for where I should have gone, because I am running a little late.
This is bad.
13 minutes. Oh, sorry, I just had to check that, see where we're at. I think I'm going to end it here, just about here, because it doesn't make sense that if I start and stop another one, it'll be another, well, start to stop this in a minute, so about 5-10 minutes, but I could do another short one. No, this works out fine, it's 3. Well, I have a minute to go. What do I want to say in a minute? Oh, I might get it. I only got a minute to go. A minute and 45 minutes of talking. You have some out of floss, you have some out of burn. I don't know, I got nothing. I have nothing good to say, I don't know. I know this is dumb. This is dumb. I know I'm probably not gonna write the most novels ever. I wanna write one, and I wanna talk. I'm just about to talk about the fucking book. It's called Joke Boat. Joke Boat. Tentative working title. About a man on a solar powered boat with two parrots named Walt and Fraser. And the other pair, he had 3. One died. That was Clyde. Walt Clyde fled free. That's my plot. And he's just a newly divorced man with parrots in the open seas. And the book kind of takes place in his head. He's remembering things. I guess, but so far I'm running in the third person, so we got to figure that part out. Okay, I got to go. The wrap-up gets 15 minutes. See you on Monday, or probably.